Whoa, you see, it was super bright. Let's turn off the lights. So guys, all of my lab lighting has been turned off. Now let's turn this light on. Okay, you see how bright it is? It's working just great. Very nice. See, it is chrome white. This inverter, guys, it is really nice. It is very, very good considering the fact that the circuit does not contains even a single IC or any complicated components. Okay, you see, working really smooth. Increasing the speed, more, more. You see? Now let's remove the terminal from the battery. Not touching it. So smooth performance. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Mr. Electron. Now, a few days back, I made this 500 watts inverter claiming that it's a sine wave inverter. Now, I never said it's a pure sine wave inverter, so I'm going to do the wave checking with this oscilloscope meter that I have. Plus, I'm also going to run a few inductive loads on this very inverter. This is a very special inverter without any IC, any capacitor, and only two resistors that are 1 kilo ohm each. And one more thing, guys, if you would like to make this very inverter at home, you can make it by going to the links provided in the description.
Okay.
Yeah. Good. Now, guys, this is 220 volts AC from my home socket. So let's first do the measurement of the AC from the home socket with my oscilloscope. Okay. Here you see AC waveform. You see, it is coming close. That is the sine wave, pure sine wave that is coming out from my home socket. Okay, so this is the pure sine wave. Okay, now I'm going to do the same test with the wave of my inverter. Yeah, the terminals have been connected as you can see. Okay, now it's time to remove this and connect this negative terminal, and then you will see the waveform. Okay, go. You see, that is the waveform of this very inverter. It is quasi sine wave. It is not pure sine wave, it is quasi sine wave because of the peaks that you see. You see the rising peaks? That's the quasi sine wave. I will give you a closer view. Here you see quasi sine wave, the peaks, and if we make the near about waveform from this, it is going to be close to sine wave. You see the peaks, and at the right lower corner you will see the frequency, which is stating 75 hertz. Okay, so 75 hertz is the frequency which lowers when you connect the load to somewhere around 60 or 55 hertz. And you can see the voltage, it is 176.3 VRMS. Okay, so guys, let's start the test. Okay, this is the negative wire that I've taken out, and I've placed the meter to the positive terminal connecting the battery. Let's see if it starts. You see that it is drawing only 3.8 amperes. Well, I never expected such a strong start. It started at a really good torque. The starting was really smooth. That is what I mean. Okay, once again, you see such a smooth and fast starting, and only 3.8 amperes. So it is drawing around 12 4s of 48. So it is drawing around 48 watts, and this fan is around 70 to 75 watts. These fans are designed to operate at 250 to 60 volts AC. But here I am giving it an input of, as you already saw in my oscilloscope meter, around 175 to 180 volts. So because the voltage is low, so that's why the speed is a little low, but the waveform is so good. Considering that I am not using any IC, it is starting the fan, induction motor fan, with such a good torque. Once again, guys, You see? I will give you a close up for the meter. I don't think you can see it. You see, that's the connections. No other wire is given.
Okay.
You see, 3.80 amperes. And the fan is working great, guys. Really nice. You see, you can hear the humming sound from the transformer. That is for sure. And there is one thing I would like from you people is if you have seen an inverter made by someone without an IC and that can run induction motor fans, just let me know in the comments. Now guys, this is the 220 volts socket which a few moments back I tested for pure sine wave. Okay, so I'm going to connect this extension to this transformer and I'm going to test my Dremel tool with it. Yeah, that has connected. Okay, now guys, this is my grinder. You see, 18 volts DC grinder. In my previous video, I used this to clean the heat sinks before placing them. You might have seen that. So I'm going to connect it. At present, it is in the off state. You see? Okay. Starting it, guys. Okay. You see? Working really smooth. Increasing the speed. More. More. You see? Now let's remove the terminal from the battery. Not touching it. So smooth performance. And guys, here I have this big LED panel. Its rating is 150 watts and operates at 110 volts as well as 220 volts, but not more than 220 volts. So yeah, I'm going to test it with this inverter of mine because it is a big load, 150 watts. And guys, link for the products will be provided in the description. You can check it out from there. So let's start my inverter. Okay, I think the wiring is not perfect. Let's see now. Whoa. You see, it was super bright. Let's turn off the lights. So guys, all of my lab lighting has been turned off. Now let's turn this light on. Okay, you see how bright it is? It's working just great. Very nice. See, it is chrome white. This inverter, guys, it is really nice. It is very, very good considering the fact that the circuit does not contain even a single IC or any complicated components. Okay, one close up. It's inverted, but anyways, 11,000 RPM, 850 watts. Okay, 220 volts. Because even a single turn is going to be great. So, turning it on. Well, it was actually already turned on. So anyways, so these are the wires coming out from the angle grinder, okay. Already connected the white wire. So it's time to connect it. Let's connect it permanently. Inverter has started. Okay, so let's touch it to the inverter and see if it works. It's making weird sound, but it is not starting. For this. Oh, you see guys, it is not running at its full potential, I understand that, but at least it is starting such a heavy inductive load. Once again. Wow.